My name is Patrick Mahaffy. I live in Boulder, Colorado, and was doing having a lot of work done in my yard. And they were doing some digging when the shovels connected with something that made a sound that was completely different than the other stone and dirt they were working with. And they found 83 or 84 of these obvious relics from some time past. And one of the guys said, you know, you got to call CU. And some others were saying, no, no, don't call anybody. They'll shut it down. They'll shut it down.
When Pat called, I wondered, you know, gave me his address, and I went up to the house, and they had all the stuff out of the ground and kind of spread out on the patio in his backyard, and it was just, it was astonishing. I mean, it was just amazing, because you just do not find stuff like this, not almost anywhere. I knew right away that a lot of the material was from the other side of the state, maybe as far up as down up into southwestern Wyoming, and the quality of the stoneworking, the skill of the people who made these things, and the effort that it took to carry them is just out. You know, it's very, very out of the ordinary. Let alone the fact that it fell out of his front yard. This material appears to be about 13,000 years old, and you can make a case for that just by looking at it. The sort of characteristics of the raw material that's been carried in from so far away, the quality and some of the patterns of the stoneworking are the kinds of things that we wouldn't be surprised to see on Clovis Age material. And so being able to make something that's extremely wide relative to its thickness is a hallmark of great skill. And this particular piece is also really cool because it is an absolute dead ringer for another artifact made of an entirely different raw material in obsidian that came out of another Clovis Age cache that was found somewhere where Idaho and Wyoming and Utah meet, called the Fen Cache. And they are the two artifacts, except for raw material, are almost indistinguishable from one another. And I'm not going to stake my reputation on saying that they're made by the same person, but it's almost that similar, that you could almost imagine the same person making them, because they're just so similar.
This one had bear protein on it. This one had horse, and this one had camel.
And this would have put us, an age of about 13,000 years, puts us right around the end of the Ice Age. And at that time, this was a very different place. And the animals that lived all over North America were very different. Elephants and camels and horses, some varieties of huge bears and ground sloths and a range of other creatures that, you know, we'd expect to see in Africa or in the zoo today wandered through Boulder. Through eastern Colorado up into the mountains during the Ice Age. And apparently, folks that left these tools behind hunted at least some of them.